Hello everyone. Today we are going to see the need for function through a simple attendance marking system. And we know our teachers call out our roll numbers in the class to mark the attendance for that particular class. And in general, what are all the two steps that involved in marking the attendance? They first call out our roll number, and based on our response, they will mark the attendance. And these two steps will be repeated for all the students in the classroom that we know. So if suppose there are 50 students in the class, then the teacher has to repeat this two step for 50 times. If I want to automate it, what are all the options available? I can make use of loop structure. So what is this loop structure? You can have a statements that need to be repeated for predefined number of times inside this loop structure. It could be either your for loop, while loop, or do while loop. Okay, how this could be done for this attendance management system? I can place the two steps where I need to call out the roll number and I have to mark the response inside the loop, and that loop has to run for the number of students in the classroom. Okay. Is it fine? Is it okay? Let me see certain scenarios. You have a sports day where you have many events, and for each event you need to take attendance of the participants. And again, you are organizing a seminar. There also you need to take the attendance of the students. And you have conducting a student workshop where you need to mark the attendance. In all the scenarios, the basic thing is marking attendance, where it varies means the sense of participants. The participants may vary in the sports event, seminar, and student workshop. They may not be fixed as in our classrooms. So how can I have a system that try module or a code that can be applicable for all the scenarios? The solution is, I can have a set of statements which will be executed only based on me. That is your function. So how this could be done? I can write a function. Let the name of the function be attendance marker. The input, it will be taking us the list of student identification number. The output, it will generate us my attendance report. So what is the task that will be performed by this function? It will simply call out student identification number, and based on the response, it will mark their attendance. That's it. We got the solution. If I'm sending the list of student identification number participating for a particular event in the sport, then I will get the attendance report for that. If I'm sending the student register numbers registered for a seminar, then I will be getting the attendance report for that. Fine. So what is the benefit I'm enjoying from that? You can have reusable capability. That is, you can invoke this particular function attendance marker based on your requirement. Where you need, you just call this function by giving the input and you get your output. Again, you can achieve modularity. What is modularity? When you are developing a large program, you can split that program into independent interchangeable modules, so that you can easily understand the functionality and you can easily debug if any error happens. These are the benefits you enjoy with the usage of functions. If you want to know, now you know why you need function. To understand what is the basis of function, how to create a function in Python, you can refer this particular article